Before we head to the auction, I'm off in search of a fascinating local story. Bristol is world famous for the graffiti that adorns its streets. It hosts Europe's largest street art festival, which every year attracts thousands of visitors and artists from all over the world. And of course, the city is home to the world's most celebrated street artist, Banksy. Famed for his anonymity, his satirical images turned him into an art world phenomenon, and his exhibitions attract hundreds of thousands of people. Street art is considered to be the latest urban art movement, and its origins are deeply rooted in the hip-hop culture that emerged from America in the 1970s. Graffiti is all about freedom of expression in a public space, and in a way it's a kind of a rebellion against the establishment. Graffiti exploded in the early 1970s in New York. Subway trains were painted as a way of marking territory. Not long after, the trend crossed the Atlantic, and Bristol was at the forefront of the underground scene, which had ties with a new sound called trip-hop that was emerging in the city, led by Massive Attack. Bristol was seen as a hotbed for music and art, and it produced and attracted talented graffiti writers. However, as the subculture saw breaking the law as a form of expression, the general public considered it vandalism and the police deemed it criminal damage. And as the spray started to spread, the authorities began to worry about the millions of pounds spent on cleaning it up. In 1989, Bristol witnessed the largest ever graffiti bust in British history, Operation Anderson. More than 70 graffiti writers were arrested. Caught in the middle of the ensuing court case was John Nation, a youth and community worker who had helped to foster talent in many of the young graffiti artists. John, you've been part of the Bristol street art scene since its beginning, what, in the 80s, really, I guess. So what's your involvement?
OK, my involvement was as a youth worker at Barton Hill Youth Club, where I set up a project working with young graffiti artists to offer them a legal space and a safe environment for them to paint and express themselves with like-minded individuals. Many artists came through that project, people like Nick Walker, Inky, including probably the one that's best known from Bristol. Though he wasn't the first artist.
So we're talking about Banksy, but Banksy wasn't the first then?
No, the main artist that first made his impression in Bristol is a guy called 3D, or otherwise known as Robert Del Nio from the band Massive Attack. Someone had to offer an opportunity to the young people in this city to try and harness the energies of what they were doing.
So this sounded like the perfect solution to the problem that the police were trying to solve. So, talking about police, so how did you end up being arrested?
I was arrested on a conspiracy to incite individuals to commit criminal damage. Self by saying that using my photograph collection or books that I had on the art would some way inspire young people to
advertise the whole fact
to go out and paint illegal. And the police, what they also tried doing was to lessen the activities of the youth club. I was acquitted, and what that meant was then the exposure was given to my work. And it set a template for other cities around the country that have started to look and engage at street art and graffiti with young people.
30 years on, street art is more popular than ever. In 2011, the very street which witnessed graffiti artists being taken to court hosted Europe's largest street art event, See No Evil. The street was transformed into a gigantic urban art gallery, which included this work above us.
That is fantastic. That's talent on the wall up there. And street art does enjoy great public acceptance, but there are other things, you know, like tagging, you know, this kind of thing. I know it's an identity and people want to be known for their tag name, but what's that all about? Why do they have to do it like that?
Many people in the general public, this is what they see as wanton vandalism. There's no constructive talent behind it, but it's indicative of graffiti culture. And tagging was the forerunner for graffiti prior to street art.
So without the tagging, if we didn't have the tagging, we wouldn't have works like that, would we?
There are many artists that started out as taggers. Banksy was when he was a young lad. That's how he started. But it's wherever they take that progression on to then start painting and then go on to develop their style in their art. This is where they all started.
And I can't wait to have a go at doing some spraying. And I'm meeting up with freehand street artist Harriet Wood, known as Miss Hazard.
Hi, Harriet. It's Paul. Hello.
Influenced by tribal art and different cultures, she was voted one of the top female graffiti artists in the UK. Now, since freehand will take me a while to grasp, she's showing me stenciling, which is also used in street art.
How are you getting?
Nearly done. It's not going to be as accurate as yours, though. I think a lot of people look at street art and they can see it done by hand. You know, they haven't used stencils, but you can use both, can't you?
Yeah, absolutely. The difference between graffiti and street art.
Yeah.
I would say graffiti's always done freehand, whereas stencils are part of the street art world, which is anything created for arts purposes, but then is put on the streets.
Well, there we are. Let's lift it off and have a look.
Good work.
Da-da-da-da! How's that?
That will work.
It's yep. Not as neat as yours, I bet.
They're different, so it doesn't matter.
This is where it gets exciting.
It
okay?
Is.
This is the bit I've been waiting for all
this
day.
This is the bit where you get to spray paint something. So the trick is have it as flat to the surface as possible.
That was all right, actually, wasn't it?
Line it up as neatly as possible over the top. You're going to do this layer just with one quite light coat.
This is the exciting bit. Yeah, it's nice. It's got a detail to it, hasn't it? It really has. It's almost come alive. It's kind of like three-dimensional.
For your first stencil,
that's pretty,
pretty good.
I want to get on the rostrum now, hammer things out. So, I'm happy with that, so thank you.
Pleasure.
You sent me on my journey with my gavel.
Well, it's not quite up to Banksy's standard. Banksy is most known for his provocative stenciled images, rich in social and political messages. One of his first pieces to raise eyebrows was not only hand-painted, but also produced legally.
And this one is arguably one of the most iconic in the city. He's even signed it, look, Banksy in stencil below. It's much loved by all the locals, and it represents the typical Bristol mindset and the heritage of this area called Stokes Croft, known for its unlicensed raves and rioting. This was painted in direct response to a particular event that happened where police clashed badly with partygoers. It's titled Mild, Mild West, and it's a reference to the Bristol people, chilled and laid back. I particularly like the fluffy, cuddly teddy bear, but then again, you know, you look closely, he is holding a Molotov cocktail, it's on fire, and he's ready to throw it. And of course, you've got the police there with their riot gear, with their shields, representing really what happened on that day. And it really is much loved by so many Bristolians.
Despite being initially thought of as a form of vandalism, Bristol has now not only accepted street art, but has embraced it. The painted streets add yet another layer to a city that is visually rich with beautiful architecture, from its Georgian buildings to its majestic cathedral.